Hey there, how you doing? Charlie Winters here with selections for Saturday the 7th of May. First of all, good morning everybody, and it's going to be a bit of a longer video, but I'm going to try and explain why I've chosen selections. So I'm not going to hang around, but if you could do me a favour, if you could like the video, subscribe to the channel, share it, spread the word, tell your friends, tell anybody you want to. Just I'm trying to grow the channel a bit, so it would be great if you could like put it on your Twitter feed. I don't know. I don't even go on Twitter. You can see how limited I am with the basic screenshot and just talk it like with a commentary behind it. But I'll also leave a link with a buy me a coffee. If you have a good day, feel free to buy me a coffee. I would prefer it if you didn't buy me a coffee before the racing. Save your money for the racing. If you have a good day, yeah, pop back. That's fine. Just buy me a coffee. That's absolutely really appreciated. But do not feel obliged. Anyway, let's get enough waffling. Let's get onto this. So first of all, I'm going to talk you through the football bets. I know a lot of you don't place the football bets. We had a very, very successful week last week. It doesn't mean we're going to win again. And also, it was also the first winning football bet I'd had. Bearing in mind, I think I'm only given about 5 out. And I think it was also maybe the only second winning Saturday that I've had. So obviously, it was a cracking Saturday last week. I know a lot of you don't put the football bet on, so I don't really want to rub it in, but the returns were fantastic. I put the bet on for £30, which is quite a lot for some people. As in, like, it is for me, but Saturdays are my blast. So, for £30, it then returned, I think it was £1,600 if I hadn't cashed out, but you know that I cashed out. I took £375 on the big bet instead of waiting another 15 seconds, then it actually came up, which would have made me 1,100 quid, which is like a bit frustrating. But anyway, enough waffling. Let's get into this. So, the first football bet, the teams kick off at 12:30. It's the last day of the championship before the playoffs. I've gone for matches, well, two of the matches, where there is still something at stake. Preston versus Middlesbrough and Luton versus Reading. Luton and Middlesbrough still need to win to give themselves any chance of reaching the playoffs. So they'll be well and truly up for it. The teams they are playing have got absolutely nothing to play for apart from a bit of pride. They'll be waiting for the whistle to blow at the end of the game and wanting to go for the after-match drink or whatever. Their mind won't be too much on the game. But don't forget, yeah, they are professionals. And the third selection is Peterborough versus Blackpool. Well, these two teams do score quite a lot of goals. At least Peterborough used to in the league below. But I saw them play against Forest and they're absolutely kicking in at times against Forest. When they needed to try and win on that on one of the last few games, which they didn't manage to do it. But I think there could be goals in all three matches. Well, the bookies have been quite tight with odds. I think really tight. I think they are expecting teams just to roll over. So I've gone for a £15 over 2.5 goals treble. Peterborough match, Preston match, Luton match. And as you'll be aware, I also like to go for the over 3.5 goals. And I've gone for a £2.50 treble. Same teams, over 3.5, over 3.5, and over 3.5. I don't know why I said that. And the same teams again, over 4.5 to £2.50 again. As you can see, the winnings are potentially a lot lower than what they were last week. But as I said, the bookies have been quite stingy with the odds this week. If I scroll down now, let me show you the different bet. A very different bet I'm going to have. Right, this is the bet. This is League Two, and there are there's a lot at stake in and around the playoffs. So I've gone for a sending off bet. So all you need to do is go to the match, which is like Bristol Rovers. The three teams are Bristol Rovers, the Mansfield match, and the Harrogate match. Bristol Rovers, if they win, and Northampton above them don't, they are promoted. Mansfield and Forest Green. Forest Green need to better Exeter's result to be champions. Mansfield also at least need a point out of their match. If they lose, they could drop out of the playoffs. And also Harrogate versus Sutton. Harrogate have got nothing to play for. Sutton United must win to keep alive their playoff chances. So these matches are a lot at stake. So what I have gone for. Be careful when you put the bet on. So if you just click on the Bristol Rovers match, go to cards, click on it, scroll down, and you'll see the betting. A player sent off. Click on it, it might still be 4-1. Then scroll a bit further down and you'll see each team player sent off. That means there must be one from each team sent off. That's 40-1. And then as you can see, it's the same for Mansfield, same for Harrogate. So and what I've had there, I've had 25p trebles. And once again, 25p doubles. You can put this, you can put the bet on at the same time, and I think it just comes to a fiver, and I think it's a really interesting bet. If you can get two of them 40-1s, what's that? 25p treble. So you got a tenner. That's 400 quid. It's unlikely to happen, but if you can get a treble, you've then got 400 quid going on to the final selection. I know it's a bit of a tall order asking for three different matches to have two players sent off in each one. But don't forget, if one player gets sent off, then in a match, two players get sent off, you've still got a double. You've got a 4-1 double, 25p, and then a pound goes on to the double sending off, and it's 40 quid. It's a nice little taste bet, which could get crazy. Keep an eye on the cash outs on this bet. But anyway, enough waffling now. Let's get to the horse racing, what you really want. Right. So here we go. Yeah, scroll down. Sorry if I'm sending you a bit buzzard by this. Anyway, 50 pence each way, lucky 15. The first selection is Juan de Montalban in the 145 at Ascot, paying six places instead of four. This has got a cracking chance. It ran well over 1 mile and four at Thirsk on the soft. I think it needed the run. I always like it when they've had a run after they've been gelded, although there was quite a bit of time in between being gelded and having its next run. It switched trainer from David O'Meara, who I do like the trainer, but it looks like he couldn't get the best out of it. And now it's, I should really wrote his name down, it's that Kevin De Foy, or whatever his name is. Philippe Foy, or whatever his name is. Have a look at the card, you'll know what I mean. I'm just making a fool of myself there. He's having a cracking season, this guy is. And I think he will improve it. Also, what's interesting is Daniel Tudhope, who's been riding for years for David O'Meara, is actually riding this horse. But the notable thing is, Daniel Tudhope has never ridden this horse in a race, even though it was trained by David O'Meara beforehand. So I'm guessing that maybe the jockey's got on well with it on the gallops. He will have ridden this horse, I'm pretty sure of that. So maybe that Kevin did. Yeah, it's probably asked him, because he's got previous experience on the horse, to ride it. So I think that kind of gives it another tick in the right box. The ground and the trip, in my opinion, is no worry. And also, this horse ran in the Italian Derby. I don't think it's a brilliant race, but it's going to be a decent race because of the prize money. I think it was trained by Andre Farb at the beginning of his career. So, I do think it's got a cracking chance, and I think he could get the best out of this horse. The second selection is Bronson in blue. I've taken SP in this. Well, what I've noticed is it's not giving me a cash out. So if you want a cash out available, I would take the price. Yeah. So although I've taken SP, I think it's probably best if you want the cash out option to take the price. This is in the 225 at Haydock, paying six places instead of four. Well, I'm going to leave a link in the description with a few of these horses, where you can watch the horse on racingtv.com. All you got to do is click the link and you can watch it, actually, any of its performances, just click on the video screen. This horse won very readily. I'm not convinced about the jockey, I don't know. He'd never seemed to pick his whip up, which is great, but it looked like he didn't really want to pick his whip up. It was like bumping this horse along, and it went straight by the other horses in its win at Leopardstown. Forget its last run on the flat. I just think they're keeping it ticking over. It came last, but I'm not interested in that one bit. This trainer, I think it's John McConnell, he's one to keep an eye on. When he brings his horses over from Ireland into the English races, the big races, you know, like your Aintree. Obviously, today at Haydock, it's a big day at Haydock. And also, he likes Cheltenham or whatever. So, yeah, I do like that horse. The big price horse, the 25-1, currently, I think it's now 28-1. Well, this horse is extremely well handicapped. I'm just hoping today's the day. It may not be, I don't know, but it's a horse I am going to keep an eye on. But I'm including it today. The horse is Orban in the 5-4 in the Victoria Cup, paying 8 places instead of 4. David O'Meara ran, I think it was 2 horses in this race last year. Escobar came 3rd in this last year. I looked at the stall numbers, and although it was soft ground, they came near side. Well, that's high numbers. Well, this horse is drawn 15. I'm guessing they're still going to go to the high numbers, even though it's good ground. Orban, it's been getting in trouble in its last 2 races, although it has been improving. But it was rated just 2 or 3 years ago far higher than it is today. And I do honestly think that a very stiff 7 furlong at Ascot is much better than the mile it's been, over the mile it's been run at recently. I think it's got a good chance of a place. I think it wasn't until I looked further into the race, just seeing how competitive it is in this race is. And I am sticking with Orban. And if it doesn't win today or run a really good race, I'm keeping an eye on this horse for future races, whether they're at Ascot during the Royal Meeting or whether he's looking for a race at York. But I am backing this horse today. It's around 28-1 currently. The 4th and final selection is Henry Hawk. I've took 10-1. I've already seen now it's 12-1. So decide what you want to do with the prices. I am recommending really that you take the prices if you want the cash out, because maybe I've got something wrong. Maybe I'm looking into it wrong, but they haven't offered me a cash out yet. Maybe they will later on. I don't know. This is in the 7:05 at Thurst, paying 6 places instead of 4. David and Nicola Baron are in fantastic form. Just off the top of my head, I'm not sure whether it's 3 or 4, but the last 3 or 4 runners have all won. So I looked at Graham Lee riding for this stable as well. Well, the last time he has rode for Nicola and David Baron was at Thirsk, and he came 2nd twice on them. So that's another tick. It doesn't mean it's going to win. This horse is drawn 8. I've always fancied low numbers at Thirsk, but I was like, mate, I was proved wrong the last time I tipped at Thirsk, where it was middle to slightly high. And even the commentator was surprised because they was expecting the low numbers. Well, this has drawn 8, which is basically heading towards smack in the middle. So Graham Lee, decent jockey. This horse has mainly ran on the all weather. It looked extremely green last year. Well, I think it will benefit from being on the turf. It's not really got an all-weather pedigree. So I think this horse will improve again from its recent run. I think it was a decent-ish run anyway, but I think it'll improve again. And I think 10 or 12-1 with 6 places, it's a decent bet. So what I've done, I've put a 50 pence each way lucky 15 on. I've also, at the same time, I've had a pound each way accumulator. I've also had... Oh, that's not it. I've gone the wrong way. I've also had 25 pence each way doubles. It only comes to £3. So I just thought it was worth having, especially if the first one wins, it gets very tasty then, because all of a sudden you've got a couple of quid each way on the other 3 horses. So finally, I have another bet. I'm not putting these on for the sake of it. I'm using my own money, as you can see. So the last bet is my main football bet. It's the same teams who are involved in the sending off ones, but they are. I've had a £15 treble, over 2.5 gold treble. Bristol Rovers, Mansfield, and Harrogate. I'm not going to. You can see there's 2 pages. I've had exactly the same bet again. In fact, I will show you. Yeah, I weren't sure what stake it had. So I've had same teams over 4.5 goals, £5 treble, and the same teams. Yeah, it's there, look. And the same teams again, £5 treble, over 3.5 goals. So they are all my bets for today. If you are maybe still looking for something a bit different, what I did notice is Jack Mitchell, who has ridden one of the selections today in the past, I thought he might have ridden it again. He's actually got some very good rides at Lingfield. So if you're one of the people who like a bet in a lot of races, that's fine. So do I. But that's my limit to how many bets I give out in a day. But keep an eye on Jack Mitchell at Linkfield. He's got four chances. He's got an 11-4 favourite. And he's also got, I think, none of his other horses. They're all about 5 or 6 to 1. So that's probably the reason why he's been tempted to Linkfield rather than riding one of my selections today. But anyway, that's enough from me. So if you've got to this point, this is 15 minutes. If you've got to this point, thank you very much. Surely it's worth a like by now. Subscribe to the channel, if you will. Fingers crossed. And there will be no selections for Sunday. So the very best of luck. Charlie Winters, over and out. Cheers, mate.